Good morning. Today is Friday, October 4th. It is day 3. I'm Carter.
And I'm Riley. Today's news is brought to you by Webb.
Sam Peterson got caught reading by Mr. Steinke.
Stop by the Media Center to claim your prize.
It's time for sports news with Noah.
Boys in grades 5 through 8 are interested in trying out for traveling basketball should stop in the office and pick up a registration flyer. Trials will begin October 14th. There will be an organization meeting for all 7th and 8th grade boys interested in going out for a school basketball this winter. That meeting will be after school in the lecture hall on Monday, October 14th. Boys in the 5th through 6th are interested in signing up for the wrestling should stop in the office and pick up a registration form. The season begins on November 12th. Before we head back to the studio, let's check out some footage of Saturday's Fire Up 5K.
We were made to be courageous. We were made to lead the way. We could be the generation that finally breaks the chains. We were made to be courageous. We were made to be courageous. We were warriors on the front lines, standing unafraid. But now we're watchers on the sidelines while our families slip away. Where are you, men of courage? You were made for so much more. Let the pounding
school comes together. What a great turnout for the 5K.
Another great thing is our school is the yearbook.
Oh man, is that last year's yearbook?
Yep, it's awesome. I got so many signatures and notes in here during the yearbook signing party. This is going to be something I will never forget.
I still can't believe I forgot to order my yearbook last year. That will not happen again.
You better order it soon. They are $25, and if you don't order by the 20th of this month, they will be $30. You would be crazy not to order it now. It is so easy. Just fill out a form and turn it into the office or go online. My mom says she already ordered mine and even had it personalized with my name. Yep, she's pretty awesome.
I gotta go call my mom.
Wait, we need to finish the broadcast.
Oh yeah. Let's head to Alexis for the weekend forecast so I can quick call my mom.
Good morning. Today will be cloudy and rainy most of the day with high temperatures only at 55 degrees. It will really cool down tonight, and tomorrow we will see the rain finally ending. The high temperature will only be 50 degrees. Sunday will also be cool with a high temperature of 50 degrees. It looks like our fall temperatures are here to stay.
Do you see the crybaby lady last week?
Yeah, why was she complaining about such great books?
Well, we had another visitor in the studio this week. Check it out.
So, a couple weeks ago, you people met my older sister, Eunice. And she was giving you some strong opinions about books you shouldn't read. Well, first of all, She's on her way down here to the sunny beach in Florida right now. Maybe she could relax a little bit and not be quite so crabby next time she talks to you. Now let me tell you a thing or two about these books that she told you not to read. First of all, that Divergent book, I read that book. I loved it. I loved the action and the factions and all the twists and the turns. I didn't have a problem going to bed. I go to bed at 8 o'clock every night. I mean, unless it's bingo night, then I stay up till 9. And then that book she was complaining about with the reality shows, do you guys want to know a secret? The reason she doesn't like reality shows? She tried out for Survivor and Wipeout, and they didn't take her. That's why she has a problem. The book itself is fantastic. But here, I am to tell you books you do not want to read, especially my first book, If You Don't Want to Sleep. And it's not that I didn't go to bed at 8 o'clock, but I had to sleep with a baseball bat next to my bed because I was so afraid. This book right here, people. Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children. Do you see this peculiar child on the front cover? She is floating in the air. And that's not it, people. There's pictures throughout this book. Sometimes I had to read the book with one eye closed because I was so scared. I'm going to show you a picture, people. I'm going to show you one. Oh, I lost my picture. There it is. Creepy. When I read this book, I literally did not sleep all night, even though I went to bed at 8 o'clock, because it scared the bejesus out of me. These hologasts, these children that can float in the air and they're invisible and they have fireballs in their hands, it's just not right. So when I got done with this book, I said to myself, I need to read a book that's going to be happy, feel-good kind of book. So I picked up this book, which I thought was going to be fabulous. Drums, Girls, and Dangerous Pies. Now the title, I said, it's kind of weird. All right, here's the problem with this book. I took it to the pool with the other ladies from my retirement community. And as I'm reading this book, I was laughing out loud. And I started to get some strange looks. And then, I'm not kidding, 5 minutes later, I had tears running down my face. These women, they've been whispering about me ever since. So I do not recommend this book because people will think you're a little bit crazy for all the laughing and the crying. So anyway, it's about time for me to head out here. I've got some water aerobics to hit up before I gotta go pick up my older sister Eunice at the airport. Till next time.
Students, get ready. Our first book fair of the year will be here soon.
If you want to pre-order Diary of a Wimpy Kid Hard Luck, please stop by the Media Center to sign up. This cost is $8.49. Books will be delivered in November.
Fifth and sixth grade activity night will be held at Middle School East tonight from 6 to 8:30 p.m.
The cost of entry is $5 or $4 with a canned good donation for the Hanover Food Shelf.
There will be a DJ, open gym, concessions, and much more. Come on out for a great time.
Thank you for watching. Have a great weekend.